Mr. Staib.
Thanks, Laura. Back here with Walter Staib, chef. What was that you made the last time? I can't even pronounce it. It was so good, though.
It's a quinoa, ratatouille salad. Made a little dragon fruit, and then seared ahi tuna on top.
Wow. I didn't think anything could top it, to be honest with you.
I watched how much you ate, so I know you liked it.
So what do we have here? What are you going to make here?
This next recipe takes it over the top. That's
really?
Why I decided to make it for you. Oh. What I have here in the bowl, I have a little brown sugar.
Okay.
I have a little coriander.
All right. Just a little brown sugar?
A little brown sugar, yeah. Like, yeah, okay. A little bit. Just a little bit.
Just for taste.
Well, the reason you need a brown sugar is to cut the acidity, because you're going to see in a moment, because the pomegranate seed have acid itself,
right.
And it's what cuts it. So basically what I did, I put a little bit of vinegar in there, and the reason I do this early, to let it dissolve. You want to make sure that the sugar and the coriander ground is dissolved, just like that.
Okay, so again, no salt.
There's no such thing as salt. That is the new salt.
Is
lime
that
juice.
Right?
Yes, sir. Anyway, so now what I do, I already have the avocado cut. So I put the avocado right in there. And avocado is a little tricky sometimes, as you well know. This one's here, I picked up in the store this morning. So look how easy. You cut them the way I like to do mine, easy for the people. Just cut them open in four, take the seed out, mm-hmm. and just chop it down like that.
And the avocado is good for you?
Avocado is very good for you. Avocado is spectacular. And then I have a little garlic here. What's the garlic in here? Garlic
how
away to chop.
What's the name of this dish?
This is just an avocado pomegranate seed, kind of like a relish, like a salsa. That's what it is for. The important part of it is, obviously you know pomegranates. They are in season right now. You see them in the stores. They're just beautiful. One piece of advice is be careful when you cut it open, when you see the thing out. Because what happens is the seeds, this is very, very staining. It has on you forever.
Mm-hmm.
Now, many stores, you can buy now the pomegranate seed already.
Already
de-seeded, just like that.
Okay.
Like I did here. So anybody sees in there?
That also adds some beautiful color to that.
No kidding. That's why Molly likes it so much. This is one of her favorite things.
Your assistant.
Assistant producer of the show, working hard on getting the recipes. We want to get the people so excited about its stuff that they have never seen it before. Got it? So I mix it up right now.
Wow. That looks good enough to eat right.
Well, it's pretty good.
Like that.
The only other thing is now the heat factor is something that you can control. We talked about it earlier.
Right.
Smell those are habaneros. Mm. Now, the habanero likes itself in there. You like it hot? Not too hot?
Yeah, sort of medium.
All right, good.
Yeah, I do like a little edge.
Okay. Now, the next thing we got to do is I need some red onion in there. And the onion, I recommend you always chop last moment to keep the flavor into it. Now, if you make a whole batch of this for like an extra day, don't put the onion in until you serve
it.
You know?
Got it.
So the onion, you just chop it up quickly. That's all you need.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And you want to reach me the peppermint over there?
Sure. Wow. On behalf of all of us, I'd like you to... That looks like an award of...
Well, I like five different peppercorns. That's why it's a mixture. I make it myself.
Is that right?
I have pink, I have white, I have black. No salt. This is the new salt.
This is the new salt.
Lime juice. But lime juice, I would squeeze it up there like that. But really, if you do it yourself, just a little bit, squeeze it in there, and you got it. And now...
Okay, a little bit of lime.
We got lime and lime. Now... Are you ready to plate it up, this gorgeous dish? And basically what I do for that, I want to give it a good amount of greens on the bottom.
Uh-huh.
I have a little frisée here.
Okay.
Frisée is just a nice lettuce that you get everywhere. Lasts up very well, frisée, and I have some bib. So I take the bib lettuce on the bottom.
Okay, a little bib lettuce.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Bib lettuce on the bottom,
that's
like so.
Mm-hmm.
And the frisée on top.
Okay.
And then I have the salmon already cooked, and the salmon is a beautiful centerpiece of salmon, like you see right there. I lay my salmon on top, and now I take a spoon and top
this. You know, this is so good, they're actually sending an emergency crew to get a taste. Wow, that looks delicious, if I can say that.
It's the idea, Doc.
It almost looks like a holiday salad.
Well, it's kind of right. This is what it's beautiful. It's simple, and the whole idea with the superfoods is don't overwork in it. Get your fork and stick it in there, and you're gonna see how gorgeous that is.
Okay.
To eat.
All right. Here we go. Oh, I probably should use the fork.
That might be better.
All right.
Take a little bit. Put a little salsa on it.
Okay.
Avocado.
All right. Mmm. I know the reporter's always supposed to go,
who's the
regardless.
Man? Who's the
but
man
this
now? Who's
is
the,
good.
Who's the man now?
You are the man. Eating but, healthy and eating well. That's the name of the game for Chef Walter Staib.
But let me tell you, you have no idea how excited I am for this new series that we're going to start taping right around the corner. Because if you eat like that, it's beautiful for the eye. It's good for the body, it's good for your mind, it's good for everything. Heart healthy food, superfoods, that's where the future is.
It's the last word about superfoods from Super Chef Walter Staib. Back to you.